Let's play Dark Souls, and I left off, well, on my way towards, so I switched to offline mode. So there's a dragon, and that was pretty awesome. You'll encounter him later. To a degree, I haven't really fought him or found a need to fight him. You can take a look around at some baddies. There's some undead. So another great thing about this game is you don't know what's coming at you. Of course, when you first play it. See, there's a guy shooting an arrow, and there's this guy. You gotta watch out, because he's got that. But if you can time your hits well enough. Yeah. This way. There's these guys, these spear guys. They're kind of interesting. They can be kind of. You gotta watch out. They have some good attack range with those spears. They have a double attack. There, you see, but they leave themselves open. I'll drink some of my Estus flask, and down here, put my shield back up, see, press the triangle. There's a guy back here.
Seem to have your wits about you, hmm? Then you are a welcome customer. I trade for souls. Everything's for sale.
And you wanna basically there's some keys you wanna purchase from him. I don't think you really need anything else. Prepare, powder, residence key. And there's no, treasure in these barrels. Oh, why did I do that? There's no treasure in those barrels or anything. Let's see. I want to go down here. Just take these guys one at a time. The circle on the ladder and you won't go down like that nice and quick. Sometimes you want to break these barrels because there could be some kind of object hidden behind them, but there's nothing in them. using it. Resets all the enemies, so you can have it. Chest. Firebombs. That's pretty much it. I believe. Alright, and we got a bunch of guys right here. Chest right here, yeah. Gold pine resin. No idea what that does yet. So we have all those baddies coming up around here. Spear guys are always fun. You can get them. there's a guy up here. Firebomb me. All right. think. I didn't think they were... I guess he did come after me after all. Alright, so once there's a trap, and it's already been unleashed on you, you don't have to worry about it anymore. So we're gonna go up here. Chase you up here, and you have to come up here. And you're gonna target him, and you're gonna jump down and hit the. I think you hit this square or whatever. Let me see. I don't think there's anything that's gonna tell me hints. We're gonna do R1 and big hit. But you can see how challenging it is. It's boss fights are not just hack and slash and throw everything you can at them. You don't, well, I mean, if you can find some powerful weapons, but usually you need help in a lot of these. So, alright, well, thanks for those of you who enjoy this game. Thanks for sticking around and being patient and watching. And stay tuned next week for another episode. Until then, stay